my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the mid-month love reading for all zodiac signs. I do want to apologize for being a little late on the mid-month readings. I have been so crazy busy. You guys have no idea. I am extremely blessed and thankful. I want to thank every one of you guys who watch my videos. Thank you so much for assisting me and helping me in growing my channel. It has quickly been growing, and I know it has everything to do with you guys. So thank you guys very much. Thank you for subscribing, liking, and sharing all my videos. I truly appreciate it. For those of you guys that have came to me for spell work, candle magic, private consultations, thank you guys very much. I'm so excited to see that you guys are getting very quick results. I am extremely blessed and very thankful. Also, if you're interested in private consultations, look at the description box below. You'll be able to find my contact information on there. For those of you guys who have private emailed me or have sent me messages through, you know, all my other media outlets, please be patient if I have not responded. I'm trying the best I can. I am extremely busy, again, like I said, with everything that has to do with, you know, spellcraft and all that. It's just been very crazy. So please be patient with that. I'll try the best I can to respond to you guys. Please don't think that I'm ignoring your messages. I'm just trying to get to them when I, you know, get a little bit of downtime. So anyways, thank you guys very much, and let's get into this reading. This is going to be for Cancer, Sun, Moon, and Rising. Let's see what Spirit has for you guys for the mid-month of November 2017 regarding your love life. I will be pulling out 4 cards for you and then 4 cards for your partner, the person that you're interested or dealing with. And then I will be pulling out the current situation card, okay? So I was shuffling. I have been shuffling for quite a while. The Three of Wands came out already, so we're going to stay with that Three of Wands. And let's see what other cards come out. Spirit, please give me the cards for Cancer. Mid-month of November 2017. I hope you guys have a very blessed Thanksgiving. For all of you guys out there, I hope you guys celebrate, enjoy each other's company, and family is very important. So okay, let's get into this. All right, so your first card that came out was the Three of Wands, Cancers. You have the King of Pentacles. Whoa. You have the Ace of Pentacles, and you have the Two of Wands. Partners cards is the Four of Cups, the Four of Swords, the World card, and the Five of Wands. Let me pull out Spirit. Spirit, please give me current situation card. Current situation card for Cancers. Oh, okay. Wow. Okay. All right, so your current situation, or the current influences in your life at the present regards to your love and romance. You have the Two of Cups. The Two of Cups definitely represents partnerships. It definitely speaks about union, and it also speaks about, I feel that for a lot of you guys, this is someone from your past that you have already dealt with. It could be an earth sign. An earth sign would be a Capricorn, Taurus, or Virgo. For others of you, this is definitely a fire sign. Fire sign would be a Sagittarius, Aries, or Leo. And for others of you, it could actually, I see all signs here. As I do see cups, which would be water element, which is a Cancer like yourself, Pisces or Scorpio. I see swords here, so it could also represent air signs, which would be Libra, Aquarius, or Gemini. So anyways, the Two of Cups is definitely, Cancers are definitely thinking for the mid-month of November. Going into the first week of December, you guys are definitely looking towards partnerships, and you're starting to scope out or pretty much determine that one person you're interested in. And the reason I say determine is because I do see the Five of Wands here. So the Five of Wands could be that in the past, perhaps for some of you guys were dealing with more than one person. Maybe you're interested in more than one person. But ultimately, at the end of the month, you will be making a choice in regards to the person that you're wanting to put effort in or you're wanting to get to know. Now, for those of you guys that are in a serious, long-term, committed relationship, the Two of Cups definitely represents being compassionate and loving to one another and trying the best you can to be compassionate and to try to support or give the support to your partner. Now, the cards that represent you at the present time is the Three of Wands. The Three of Wands is looking towards the future, but also slightly looking towards the past. So the Three of Wands definitely represents you, Cancer, are constantly looking back or thinking or missing a person. Again, like I said, it could be a Pentacles. It could be an Earth sign. So it'd be a Capricorn, Taurus, or Virgo. Or it could be the fear. There's some fear involved here. And for some of you guys, it could be that you fear they may never reach out to you. The King of Pentacles, again, doesn't have to be their sun sign, could be their moon or rising. And the King of Pentacles is definitely a person that is a professional. It's someone that, you know, is very stable in regards to their life. And this is you waiting for them to reach out. And the message definitely does come through as you do have the Ace of Pentacles here. The Ace of Pentacles is the beginning process. In love readings, I always prefer to get the Ace of Pentacles, as the Ace of Cups is definitely it's a good omen in regards to love and romance, as it speaks about having the possibility of having emotional stability. But with the Ace of Pentacles, it's definitely a promise that it will materialize into something more structured or something more long-term. So this is your cards, and this is how you're seeing the situation. So again, like I said, for some of you guys, you may be dealing with an earth sign. For others, it may be a fire sign, water, air. I see everything here. So anyways, the message is very thorough, though. You guys are looking towards the future. Hoping or wanting to hear from them, the message definitely does come through. It may come through at the end of the month. The Ace of Pentacles definitely represents message and communication, but it also represents a new beginning. So for some of you guys that were dealing with a person that never really took off or never really put, like, it never went to the next level, whether it was circumstantial or whether it was because you, Cancer, didn't put enough effort, or whether it was because the partner you were dealing with didn't put enough effort, there's definitely going to be a given another opportunity to actually make it something more long-term or more, you know, something that you both actually are on the same page and wanting to put effort and move forward. Now, the Two of Wands here, again, like I said, the communication definitely comes through at the end of the month. Two of Wands, again, partnership. So you guys have to choose. So there's definitely partnerships are very important for the mid-month of November going all the way to December. I do want to mention, for those of you Cancers that have been dealing with more than one person, I highly encourage you guys to actually take some time and meditate, or take some time to actually determine who are the people that you could see yourself long-term, if that's what you're looking for. Because I feel you guys go more for the thrill. And what that means in the long run is that, you know, the thrill is always something temporary. It's never long-term. So when the fire goes out, then you find yourself in a situation where you don't want to be, because there's no depthness to it. And Cancers are all about, you know, having that emotional connection. They're all about, you know, having those long, you know, night conversations, feeling love, feeling, you know, at home, at ease. So again, you know, for some of you guys that are single and have been single for a while, and are more in the immature type of energy, meaning if you guys are, you know, young, maybe not that experienced, it's fine to have more than one suitor. It's fine to go out and have fun. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. I just want to prevent you from putting your effort, or basically putting all your eggs in one basket and that basket is broken. Okay, so be careful about that. Go for the person that you find more commonalities with in regards to love and romance. Someone that has the same aspirations or goals as you do, because they will push you and they will bring out the best in you, and vice versa. Now, anyways, how your partner's viewing the situation. The Four of Cups definitely represents an offer that was given and they were not interested. So it could be that, again, it could be vice versa. It is a general reading. So it could have been that you weren't putting as much effort, Cancer, or it could be that the partner that you were interested in wasn't that interested, as the Four of Cups definitely represents boredom, but it also represents not putting effort because they're not interested. Now, the Four of Swords, there was an ending of communication or there's been a stop of communication. But the World card right under the Ace of Pentacles is there was an ending cycle. And with that ending cycle, you go back to the Ace. So again, it's like the person didn't want to deal with you or you didn't want to deal with them no longer, but they will come back around and you guys will have a second chance at getting to know each other or putting effort or, again, like I said, being on the same page. The Two of Wands right under the Five of Wands, again, like I said, passion is being ignited and communication. When this message comes through, it's going to be a message about really wanting to take it to the next level and really commit themselves to the relationship or putting effort into it for it to unfold into a serious monogamous relationship. Now, for those of you guys that have been in a long-term committed relationship, again, like I said, the Three of Wands and the Four of Cups could represent you guys looking towards the future, wanting to look towards the future, and your partner may have been not as interested or maybe not very sexually active recently, or at least, you know, in regards to the love, you know, the love type of energy. You guys just haven't been, it's like you guys have been not synced. One is like wanting to turn right and the other is wanting to turn left. Finally, communication does come through. Again, like I said, you guys are being able to hash it out and talk about it and decide to move forward. Now, for others of you, it could represent that, you know, if you've been in a long-term committed relationship and it was your partner, the one that walked away or wanted to give each other some space or some room, there is definitely an ending of that cycle, an ending of the fighting, an ending of the miscommunication. You guys are back on the same page and the message definitely comes through by the end of the month. Again, like I said, what I mean by space doesn't necessarily, for those of you guys that are married, it doesn't necessarily mean like you guys just, you know, separate. It could just be that you guys are living together but not communicating as much or not having sex, plain and simple. But finally, you know, the connection comes about again and you guys are both in the same, wanting the same goals or focusing on the same aspirations and being able to move forward, putting effort on both sides. Okay, so I hope you guys enjoyed this reading. Like, share, and comment. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, definitely subscribe, and we will see each other soon. Okay, bye.